You've completed your check socket fittings and now you're ready to transfer. Here's a quick tip to transfer your trim lines most accurately. Hi, I'm Jeff, CPO with Ottobock, and this is O&P Workshop Insights. We're gonna start with placing in your jig and taping up the socket. I always start from the posterior, and I'm gonna make sure that the tape is sealed really nicely around the edge of the trim line. Going to work my way up, piece by piece, building up the posterior, flattening out any imperfections there, and then I'll start wrapping around towards the anterior and sort of flatten out around the trim line edge. I like to use the back of my hand on the inside so that it doesn't stick so bad, and I have good amount of control with that. Be sure that you tape to at least 2 to 3 centimeters above your trim lines. Smooth it down. Check the mandrel to make sure it's properly aligned. Another tip with mixing plaster, no one likes to sit around waiting on cold plaster to set, so use warm water. I'll warm this up ahead of time. If you're in a very humid climate and this isn't setting up fast enough, you can also add regular table salt and that will set it off very quick. I'll begin with turbulent water, mixing in my plaster. The consistency I'm looking for is about like melted ice cream. Okay, we're gonna pour in now. And make sure you pour it higher than the top of the trim lines by at least 1 to 2 centimeters and place in your mandrel. It's a good idea to vibrate out any of the air bubbles here. And within about 1 to 2 minutes, this is gonna set up to where you can remove the tape. Be sure that you're not walking away and then coming back. You wanna make sure that you come back to it when it's still a little bit gelatinous, but firm. Take a razor blade and place a cut down the middle, and you can see the tape is pulling away, even though the plaster is still a little bit wet. And this is intentional. I'll use this tape as a palette and using a tongue depressor while the plaster is still wet, I'll begin smoothing down around the edges of the trim line, carving any excess lips off of there and just kind of scraping it nice and clean. This is especially nice when you're transferring a transfemoral socket. You can pull some from the back, bring it around to the front if you need. And while you're at it, to save your PVA bag, come around the top and skim off that sharp edge. Now, the plaster is set after just a very short amount of time, and we are ready to remove it. Now we're going to cut down the posterior wall, making sure not to hit the valve. And I'm looking for a depth that's just below your thermoformed plastic.
I'm going to insert my cast spreaders and slightly depress while removing.
And now we're ready to finalize our trim lines. This next step is really important. Using my SureForm rasp, I'm going to trim down the edges of the trim lines. So as they stand, they're about 5 millimeters in thickness. We're going to shave it down in a nice, long pulling motion all the way around, making sure I don't come into the actual model itself, staying above the trim line and carving to it. And we're looking for about 2 to 2.5 millimeters of thickness. And that's going to allow you to easily see your trim lines through the carbon or fiberglass whenever you laminate and give you very accurate trim line edges. So many times during transfer, your trim lines end up getting shaved off and you end up with a short socket because of it. Approaching it in this manner will allow you to maintain the same height of trim line and have a much cleaner look in your final product. You can also do this with a full round. If you want deeper trim lines to be able to refer to, for instance, if you're pulling a flexible inner socket and then laminating over that, you can cut in even deeper here. Now we have very well-defined trim lines to work with. If you are pulling a flexible inner and you really want to define those trim lines, this is that extra little touch that you can do. Just be careful not to shave off the trim line when you're coming around these tight corners. It requires a little bit of practice and patience and finesse. Lastly, if you want to further define this, like if you're going to another check socket, you can color this in with your indelible marker right on that edge. Or if you are 3D scanning to transfer to a 3D printed socket, this is a good way to define those lines in your scan. And there you have it. Very well-defined trim lines ready for transfer. Let us know what you think in the comments and be sure to check out our other tips and tricks at Ottobock Professionals.